Good morning, and welcome to St. Thomas the Apostle Church as we celebrate the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. A few announcements before we begin. The bathroom to the left of the altar and past the elevator up the steps is now open, but we are still trying to minimize its use as much as possible, but as able. Thank you for continuing to make your online reservation for Mass. You can visit our website for more information. Next weekend, there will be 100 people allowed to Mass, so it's important to get those reservations in so we can prepare. Today's Mass will be recorded and posted on the St. Thomas YouTube channel later this afternoon. And we are very blessed to welcome Archbishop Blair as our presider and homilist. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. My brothers and sisters, what better way to celebrate this beautiful sunny Sunday than to come together as a family of faith, united with those who are not with us today, but hopefully will be able to participate by means of the recording that's being done of this Mass, to celebrate the gift of life that comes to us from the resurrection of Christ from the dead, united with him in his body, hearing his word and receiving him in the Holy Eucharist. We can rejoice in God even in the midst of our challenges as we celebrate the gift of our faith. So today, as we begin, let us first call to mind our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were just Lord, have mercy.
We need to all sinners, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord, seated at the right hand of the Father to receive Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people who love you. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, "You, son of man, I have appointed watchmen for the house of Israel. When you hear me say anything, you shall warn them for me. If I tell the wicked, 'O wicked one, you shall surely die,' and you do not speak out to dissuade the wicked from his way, the wicked shall die for his guilt, but I will hold you responsible for his death. But if you warn the wicked, trying to turn him from his way, and he refuses to turn from his way, he shall die for his guilt, but you shall save yourself." The word of the Lord. Our second reading is from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, owe nothing to anyone except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not kill, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and whatever other commandment there may be, are summed up in this saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no evil to the neighbor, hence, love is the fulfillment of the law. The word of the Lord.
To Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, if your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Amen, amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. The Gospel. The Lord.
I'm really very happy to have this opportunity to celebrate Mass publicly for the first time in a very long time. And even though it's under the restrictions that we all face, here we are as a community of Catholic faith around the Holy Eucharist, and I'm very pleased to be able to do this. At the same time, I must tell you how I share your concern, your prayers, your love for your pastor, Father Moran, that he will continue to make a good recovery. His illness and his age, as well as my age, reminds me of how much we need the ordination of priests in our church. I ordained one priest this year. Hopefully next year I will ordain two, but it falls far short of what the needs of our Catholic people are. And just a reminder that you've heard from me before, that vocations to the priesthood religious life, and dare I say, even to the Catholic Christian sacrament of matrimony, comes from your families, from your community. And so it's so very important for all of us to pray and work and encourage these vocations in our church. The very first book of the Bible comes to my mind when I hear today's readings as a kind of prelude to what I'd like to share with you. And what I'm thinking of particularly is the story, the episode about Cain and Abel, the sons of Adam and Eve. After Adam and Eve committed the first sin, things go downhill very fast after that. Cain murders his brother Abel. And when God, who already knows what happened, confronts Cain and asks, "Where is your brother Abel?" Cain lies and says, "I do not know." And then he adds a rather snarky question back to God, "Am I my brother's keeper?" Now, when we're cornered about something bad or mean that we've done to someone else, don't we wind up thinking along the same lines as Cain? Am I my brother's keeper? Am I my sister's keeper? Am I my neighbor's keeper? Why should I really be concerned about them? Especially if they started it by doing something wrong or hurting me. Let them take care of themselves. But that's not what God says. God's question to Cain was meant to tell him and us that he, God, holds us responsible for one another. Not only must we avoid revenge or hurting one another, but far more than that, we must help and respect one another. And I don't think I need to tell you, my brothers and sisters, what a timely message and a timely lesson that is for our world today. Faced with so much political, social, and racial turmoil, not only in our country, but elsewhere too, that we are our neighbor's keeper, that we must help one another, that we must be concerned. And for all that, today's readings for this Sunday tell us even more. We are our neighbor's keeper, not just for their well-being in this world, not just for the social, temporal, material well-being of others, but imagine we are also our neighbor's keeper for heaven, not just their bodies, but also their souls. The most neighborly good we can wish for another person is that they come to know Jesus and his church, that they live as Jesus commanded, and eventually get to heaven, which, by the way, every page of the New Testament tells us is not a slam dunk for anyone. We all need to help one another as much as we can spiritually, even when it means challenging one another with uncomfortable truths. In the first reading today, God appoints the prophet Ezekiel to be a watchman over Israel. Whether he likes it or not, Ezekiel is his neighbor's keeper. He can no longer sit back in silence in the face of people's sins. And what does God say? "If you do not speak out to dissuade the wicked from his way, the wicked shall die for his guilt, but I will hold you responsible for his death. But if you warn the wicked, trying to turn him away from his way, and he refuses, he shall die for his guilt, but you shall save yourself." Then in the second reading, St. Paul tells us owe nothing to anyone except to love one another. St. Paul is a living example of the saying that there is no greater love than to wish a person eternal life. That's really what his profound, deep charity and zeal were all about, wishing eternal life to his hearers through faith in Jesus Christ. Precisely out of love, St. Paul could be very bold, even harsh, in telling it like it is to his fellow Christians. It was not Paul's idea of love to meekly sit by and let his neighbor walk a path to hell because of sin, because of vices, because of evil habits. And lest we have any doubt that we are our neighbor's keeper, Jesus himself assures us that it is our responsibility as members of the church. That's what he says in today's gospel. Yes, Jesus commands us to feed the hungry, shelter the homeless, care for the sick, and many other acts of charity. But he also tells us today that when sin arises, it needs to be confronted, sometimes privately, sometimes by a wider group, but confronted nonetheless. Think for a moment of someone you don't like, or someone you think has wronged you, has done something bad. It may make you angry. It may make you hurt or afraid. But God says that you and I must do our best to help that person by what we say or do, because why? We are all our neighbor's keeper. We have to be concerned about them and want them to follow the right path. And if they've done wrong, we want them to repent of it and to have a change of heart. So when someone does something to us, don't walk away mad or write them off or talk about them behind their back, but instead pray. Pray to God to help them, and also try our best to be kind to them. Gathered in the name of Christ, present among us at this Mass, we know that he alone can give us the strength, the courage, to be truly our neighbor's keeper by doing what St. Paul says and paying the debt of love for one another as Christ has loved us.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate with the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
We have all gathered here, dear brothers and sisters, to celebrate the mysteries of our redemption. Let us therefore ask Almighty God that the whole world may be watered from these springs of all blessing and life.
For God's holy church throughout the world, and for all entrusted with the ministry of the gospel, we pray to the Lord. For all students and teachers, that the Lord may bless them in the upcoming academic year and keep them close to himself, we pray to the Lord. For college students, especially those who are away from home, that the Lord may bless them in their studies and keep them from harm, we pray to the Lord. That parents may always honor and respect their role as the first teachers of the Catholic faith, we pray to the Lord. For those who are in prison, especially those condemned to death, may they be treated with the respect due to every person, we pray to the Lord. As we have received the blessings of our Lord, no matter how large or small, may we find it in our hearts to be charitable and help those in need by supporting the Archbishop's annual appeal. We pray to the Lord. For the sick, that they may be comforted and healed according to God's will, especially Judith Doherty, Father Edward M. Moran. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died, that they find peace in the arms of our Lord's embrace, especially Raymond Marcel, Joan Schweitzer. We pray to the Lord.
On this Labor Day weekend, for all of those who are suffering as a result of the pandemic, for those who are experiencing financial difficulties, who have been laid off or furloughed, that together as a community of faith and as a nation, we may address the needs of those who are suffering in this way, and that they might find consolation and strength in their faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May your mercy, we beseech you, O Lord, be with your people who cry to you, so that what they seek at your prompting, they may obtain by your ready generosity, through Christ our Lord.
Okay.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just to give you glory, Father most holy, for you are the one God, living and true, existing before all ages and abiding for all eternity, dwelling in unapproachable light. Yet you, who alone are good, the source of life, have made all that is, so that you might fill your creatures with blessings and bring joy to many of them by the glory of your light. And so in your presence are countless hosts of angels who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your face, glorify you without ceasing. With them we too confess your name in exultation, giving voice to every creature under heaven as we acclaim. Holy, 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 heaven and earth. We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great, and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior. Made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, he shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners, freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart, joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved to his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Thank you. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death. Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Thank you.
Just a kind reminder once again to please keep your mask well positioned as you come up to receive communion. Our ushers will be guiding the pews one by one. Receive in hand while wearing your mask, then step to the side, demask, consume, remask, and then go return to your pews to the side aisles. Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
God has given us a beautiful weekend, and so I wish you a restful Labor Day as we continue to be spiritually close to one another by our prayers in these challenging times. I'm grateful again for this opportunity to be able to celebrate Mass with all of you, including those who will be able to view it remotely. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.